Hi, Eric. What can you tell me about Magnelab Rogowski coils?
Hi, Victor. Yes, the Magnelab Rogowski coil is a flexible, split-core current sensor that can be used to monitor from 25 amps up to over 15,000 amps. The output is a voltage output that, in our case, runs 70 millivolts per 1,000 amps through the center of the coil. That then is put through a Magnelab integrator, which converts that to a third of a volt, which is a standard in the industry, at your rated current. Or, in some cases, there are meters out there that can take the raw output of the coil directly.
And how do you install this Rogowski coil?
The coil is simply installed by opening it here at the connector, placing it around the conductor to be under test, and snapping it closed. It's that simple.
That looks a lot simpler than installing a traditional current transformer in a tiny power panel like this.
Correct.
Now, what if I still, I mean, this is small, but what if I have a need for something even smaller?
Magnelab makes a variety of sizes and a few different shapes. This one is an example of what we call the teardrop because of its shape. That can be fed around the same conductor and then pulled closed and zip tight, be held in place in a small area.
And what would you use a Magnelab Rogowski coil for exactly?
Current transformers in general are used for power monitoring. In many cases, the space is small or the conductor is large and the average CT is not convenient to use. In that case, the Rogowski coil is a great solution.
So just about any place I can use a regular CT, I might be able to use a Rogowski coil.
That is correct, as long as you use a meter or data logger that accepts the voltage output.
Okay, and why do I want to monitor my power with a Rogowski coil or a CT?
Power monitoring is critical in the area of power savings. It's also commonly used to monitor equipment in a manufacturing facility or even a grocery store to look for the trends in the power consumption. If a piece of equipment starts to increase in its power consumption, you know something is starting to go wrong. And in a grocery store, the freezers can monitor the power. And as they start to draw more and more power, they know that things are starting to wear out and then get a technician to repair it before it goes wrong and before they lose food or before you have downtime in your factory.
Thank you for explaining that. And I mean, these look pretty lightweight. Are they gonna be as accurate as a regular current transformer?
The Magnelab Rogowski coils are actually 0.5% accurate for the current that's passing through them. In other words, you're gonna have 0.5% accuracy in your current measurement.
With a traditional current transformer, I'm used to using a shorting block to avoid being shocked by those leads. Do I need to use a shorting block with the Rogowski coil?
You do not. With the Rogowski coil, it inherently produces a small voltage instead of a current, like a standard 5-amp current transformer, so there's no danger of shock. Again, 70 millivolts per 1,000 amps. Most of the Magnelab transformers or current transformers are pre-burdened to produce a small voltage at the rated current. Therefore, you can install them on a live conductor with no shorting block and no worry about being shocked.
So after it's installed, what do I do exactly with these terminal wires?
Most of the time, the terminals are already tied to the Magnelab integrator system. Then the output leads of the integrator system would go to your meter, just like a traditional CT. In some cases, the meter can accept the Rogowski coil raw, and then I would refer you to the owner's manual of that meter to determine how to wire it up.
Well, thanks for your time, Eric, and thank you for watching this short video on Magnelab's Rogowski coils. For more information, visit magnelab.com or email us at info@magnelab.com.